Waimea Bay, Oahu, Hawaii. This is a presentation of Stafford Surf School. I try to post these videos every couple days, so please subscribe to my channel. Off Cam Highway in Waimea Beach Park lies the great granddaddy of all big wave arenas, Waimea Bay. This spot's history is as thick as its lips. Greg DeBull Knoll rode the first wave there in 1957, and since then it has become a fitting barometer for a waterman's knowledge, commitment, and courage. Even with the current tow-in phenomenon earning its place in the spectrum, not to mention darker, sharkier waves popping up in various corners of the world, Waimea still has more history and lore behind it than any other big wave break ever. And it still holds its own against any in terms of ferocity. The classic Waimea setup is formed when a northwest swell strikes a pothole indented black lava shelf lying deep below the surface. The sheer mass of this wave is enough to kill most of those who attempt it, and riders here are required to be in peak physical condition and be one with their equipment. Many of Waimea's best watermen spend months training for that one special day. This is one spot where experience and ocean knowledge far surpass athletic skill and determination. Not to say a big dose of those two ingredients isn't needed as well, it's just that Waimea Bay truly represents what Hawaiian big wave surfers are all about. When a decent 25-foot swell hits the bay during its waiting period, quote, the eddy, officially called, quote, the Quicksilver in memory of Eddie Aikau, end quote, is held here in memory of Waimea's long-lost favorite son. This event is perhaps the most prestigious of any surf contest in the world, and just getting invited, even as an alternate, is an honor in itself. Like Todos Santos, the wave face at the bay is marked by huge boils that are capable of dragging a person under the water and literally shooting them towards shore. The waves are immense, the currents are beyond treacherous, and the only way to the beach is through the east end of the bay. If you miss that spot, which isn't difficult to do, then you must paddle all the way around the length of the bay or attempt to make it in through the shore break. The shore break is formed when northwest winds push the sand in, and it can, has, and will snap a surfer's bones like toothpicks quicker than he can say, going left. So with all the potentially life-threatening elements, what makes Waimea worth it? Most will attest to it being the drop. The drop is what keeps surfers coming back. For many big wave heroes, nowhere is the adrenaline more intense than taking a few extra strokes before dropping over that voluminous ledge. At Waimea, although you may feel alone when plummeting over the falls into oblivion or racing off the bottom for the shoulder, you're not alone. No one is. All of the surfers who made themselves legends there are watching. Eddie's watching. God is watching.